Hey y'all, here we are, Vietnam War Flight Museum, and here we are right next to the F100, which we are going to finally attempt to fly today. It's been since 2018 since this thing last flew, and of course in collaboration with Collings Foundation, who owns the jet, Vietnam War Flight Museum here, we've been putting countless days and nights and weeks and months into getting this thing going. We've been, you know, spending money on getting the right parts to fix it and get her in tip-top shape and ready for today. We've got a lot of people around today who are very excited, and rightfully so. This thing is just such a cool piece of history. We're so just honored to have it here, and that's why we've been putting so much effort into it. So Collings Foundation's F100F, right here collaborating with Vietnam War Flight Museum, Rick and the guys and me, and we've all just been working so hard on it, and Chris, and just everybody. Thanks to all the volunteers who've made this happen, and let's go flying. This is gonna be fun. Thanks. At the beginning of the runway, right before we take off, we're going to actually test a few things. We're going to close the canopy, as you saw. We closed and locked it. We're going to run the engine up just a little bit, and we're going to actually test the canopy seal, the pressurization, make sure everything's working and looking the way it's supposed to. We'll actually open the canopy and close it a couple times, make sure the pressurization is, of course, dumping, and then resealing, along with a few other things that we're taking a look at here.
right, so here we are coming out to line up on the runway. And I got a few things I want to call out for Rick since he's paying attention to plenty in the front seat up there. I'm going to call 100 knots for him, which is his cue to turn the nose wheel steering off. And also I'll be calling 150 knots and then our rotation speed of 170 so knots as well. So let's listen to this thing spool up and let's go for a ride. So at this point we're in downwind. You can see Ellington off our left wing there in the right side of your screen. And we're just staying a little bit above traffic pattern altitude, coordinating with the tower. And the whole point is just to stay within the boundaries of the airport and check the systems. Make sure everything is looking and sounding and feeling the way it's supposed to. Rick's checking some stuff in the front. He's asking me to look around at some stuff in the back. We're verifying front and back are agreeing. Everything's looking pretty good. And for this first turn in the pattern, as you can see, we're just going to stay high, overfly the runways, have a place to go if we really need to before we descend into the traffic pattern. Coming in for our first low approach of the day, and we're just checking to make sure everything looks good as if we were going to land. We got the gear and flaps down, the slats are working like they're supposed to, the speeds are looking good, and we're gonna plan to go around. So full power, full afterburners coming up, the gear will come up, and you'll notice there's quite a bit of condensation that comes into the cockpit. That is normal. Don't worry about that. It's a humid day, we had a lot of power coming in, so it's not smoke, it's actually condensation from the air conditioner. As we turn final here for the full stop landing, I'll give you a couple things to look for. After we touch down, we're looking for 180 knots is the maximum speed for the drag chute. We like to use 160, so you'll see me actually call 160 knots for Rick. He'll wait till about 150 and he'll deploy the chute. And if you look closely, you'll actually see the chute pop out.
All right, we are back. I literally just got out of the jet, and that was awesome. Test flight went really well. Everything worked the way it was supposed to work as far as we could tell. And Rick's still on the plane. I already got out. I had a lot less to do before I could get out, and was excited to, you know, record this video for y'all, and just wanted to throw it together. So I did have a couple of cameras going. We were working with a couple other people that also had cameras, so I have a feeling we have a pretty good video to put together for you guys. And it was really awesome, and I can't wait to share this with you.